Welcome into NFL Daily. I am Tom Downey, and we are 1 week away from the NFL's Black Monday when NFL coaches everywhere find themselves getting fired. So we're going to run through eight coaches from 1 to number 8 that I think might get fired. I'll also make my predictions as well. We begin with what I consider to be the most obvious name on this list, someone who I think should have already been fired. That is Matt Nagy, the Chicago Bears head coach. My formal prediction, it should surprise none of you, he gone. I don't see how Matt Nagy can keep his job at this point. He's not good. Frankly, I believe that both Matt Nagy and GM Ryan Pace have to go. I don't think they're that great at their particular jobs. Letting Ryan Pace pick another head coach after, remember, he's the one who paid Mike Glennon all that big-time money, doesn't really seem right or fair. We've seen GMs get fired for less. Why would we believe in Ryan Pace? I don't like it when organizations only move on from one or the other of their head coach-GM combo when they're struggling. That doesn't often work out. If you're going to reset, do it right. Nagy, Pace to an extent as well, should have already been fired. They've not done a good job with Justin Fields this year. The game plan has not been built around their unique quarterback's talents. That's a failure of a coaching staff. When you're not doing everything possible to make life easier on your players, I think it means you suck at your job. That's my mindset. So who do you think will be the next head coach fired? This might come down to the timing of the decision. Do they make the move Sunday night? Do they do it Monday morning? Does one team get a deal, fire one at 9 a.m., the other at 10 a.m.? Make your predictions. Who is the next NFL head coach fired? For me, my next name on this list, Mike Zimmer of the Minnesota Vikings. He's had a nice NFL coaching career. He's not as bad as Matt Nagy, but I think he gets fired as well. I think at this point, it's just time for Mike Zimmer. Though I think the Vikings this year had to make the playoffs. And they laid an egg down the stretch against the Rams. Again, they had a real chance of winning. And then, if you watch the Packers game, it was not a very good showing. Zimmer, by the way, seemed simultaneously resigned and almost accepting of his fate that I think he's not going to be around. It is not often you see a head coach so bluntly just rip into one of his own young players. Mike Zimmer asked post-game, hey, do you want to see more of Kellen Mond in Week 18? Not particularly. Why, coach? I see him in practice. Tell me the player sucks without telling me the player sucks. That is an absolute bodying that you do not see very often in the NFL. Zimmer, out of Fs to give. He's tired of this team. I think at some level he's almost okay with being fired. It's just time for those sides to part ways. So if we include the two already fired coaches, John Gruden, Urban Meyer, how many NFL head coaches total will be fired this year? I'm going to make this question the pinned comment on today's video. So if that ad break comes on YouTube, take advantage of it and make your predictions for me in the comments. Number three, Vic Fangio of the Denver Broncos. I think that Fangio, like Zimmer and Matt Nagy, get fired as well. Fangio's not a bad coach. He's a great defensive mind. And the Broncos weren't terrible this year. But once again, the Broncos have missed the playoffs and finished below, guaranteed at this point, under 500. Oh, by the way, they collapsed down the stretch. They were in the mix for a playoff spot, and they could not deliver. I know their quarterback situation is not great, but Pat Shurmur is not a good OC either. I think if you're Denver, given how close you are overall with the way your roster is built, go hire a good offensive guy and pair him with a new quarterback as well. I think Fangio is going to have another continuously long career like he's had for a while now as a great defensive coordinator. Unfortunately, I think he's a lot closer to a Wade Phillips than, you know, I'll go extreme Bill Belichick defensive mind, right? I think in the end, he's a great defensive coordinator, not the head coach that you want. If you want to bet on the NFL this week, week 18, there are plenty of lines available, plus plenty of playoff bets to make as well. With our sportsbook partner, BetUS, head over to chatsports.com/bet. Use the promo code you guys see right there on screen. That is NFL Daily. If and when you put down $100, they're going to give you an extra $125 for free. Again, you must use promo code NFL Daily at chatsports.com/bet. Number four, and this is where I'm not sure really what happens. I feel good about those first three names, Nagy, Zimmer, Fangio, getting fired. Pete Carroll, I'm not so sure on. My prediction, which could very well end up being wrong, is that Carroll and the Seahawks in some capacity end up parting ways. This could be a mutual decision. This could be Pete Carroll lands a cushy golden parachute job somewhere in the front office, not doing all that much work in the end. I'm not overly confident in this particular path. Seattle did just extend Pete Carroll, but I do think big change is coming for this organization. I don't really think both Russell Wilson and Pete Carroll are going to be back in Seattle without some more changes. Yeah, they blew out the Lions. They suck. And they didn't play that well back in the games that actually mattered. I don't know if the Carroll-Russ relationship, as productive as it was, and it was immensely productive in the NFL, is really going to continue beyond this year. Seattle might have to choose between your aging head coach or your aging franchise quarterback. So which one would you keep? Type RW for Russell Wilson or type in PC for Pete Carroll. If Seattle picks Carroll and or Russ demands his way out, there will be a ton of trade rumors around Russell Wilson this season, and you better believe we will be including a lot of Russell Wilson trade rumors as those inevitably pop up in the offseason. So subscribe right now for daily videos in the offseason. I know the season's going on. We love to have NFL draft, free agency, and trade talk here on Chat Sports. Number five, Joe Judge. I'm going to try to make my boy producer Marshall proud on this one. To be blunt, Joe Judge sucks. Despite that, I think he stays. I think the Giants and an organization that doesn't like change, doesn't like to go outside of the organization for GM hires, is going to allow Judge a stay of execution to stick around as the head coach for one more year. I hope I'm wrong on that, because the Giants should fire him. Ever since the Giants leaked slash announced they were going to roll it back with Judge and Jones in 2022, the team's been a disaster. They are a joke right now. It is 2022, and in an actual NFL game in which you got your butt kicked, you have negative net passing yards. That is a fireable offense. Get rid of everybody. I don't care if Mike Glennon's your quarterback and your offensive line is bad. You finish with negative net passing yards, you are not trying to win a football game. You're just trying to get out of there with as little embarrassment as possible, which still ended up not happening. The last time negative net passing yards happened, 1998. The Chargers, Ryan Leaf, Kevin Gilbride. That head coach, by the way, got fired. June Jones came in as the replacement. The Giants need a full reset. Don't just fire your incompetent GM and stick with your head coach and just promote Kevin Abrams. That's not going to work. The Giants have to acknowledge the truth. They're a bad football team. And giving Joe Judge another year just delays the inevitable. He's not the guy for New York. That offensive performance, and by the way, a bad special teams effort from a special teams coordinator, can't have it, man. So what would you guys do if you were the Maras? Would you keep or fire Joe Judge? FJ for fire Judge, or KJ for keep Joe Judge? Let me know what you guys have to say in the comments. Matt Rhule is next up here, and I know many Panthers fans who watch this show are down to fire Matt Rhule. I would be okay with that too, but I think he sticks around. Now, I think ownership is mad. I don't think owner David Tepper is happy with the the developments for Carolina. Because remember, earlier this year, they went all in. They, not all in, but they got aggressive. They traded for C.J. Henderson. They traded for Stephon Gilmore. And after a hot start to the year, this team was a disaster. The quarterback decisions in particular, it's not it. You dump Cam Newton, which made sense in a bubble. You bring in Teddy Bridgewater. Okay, he's going to be your stopgap for the time being. It's a process, right? You dump Bridgewater. You go all in on Sam Darnold, who you are stuck with now next year. He's cheeks, has never been good. He fooled you again. And then you got to bring back Cam Newton, who you cut in the first place. And honestly, Newton kind of outplayed Darnold. It's a problem for this team. And that quarterback decision, I think in the end, falls on the guy who has final say over the roster. And that is Matt Rhule. So I think he's back next year. But his seat is going to be scalding entering the season. I would not be surprised if there is a mid-season change involving Matt Rhule. That's how big of a disappointment he has been so far. Do you think he is the guy in Carolina? I think he's better as a college coach than he is an NFL head coach, unfortunately. Why for yes and for no? Let me know what you guys have to say in the comments. Now for guys that I think are just maybe worth monitoring a little bit. Mike McCarthy, who I do think is an unquestionable upgrade over Jason Garrett. And I do think he sticks around as the Cowboys head coach. Let's remember, Jerry Jones gave his adopted son, Jason Garrett, 10 years when he should have had maybe 5. But what if Dallas plays poorly against Philadelphia in Week 18? And what if they get blown out in the wild card? You've got two promising young coordinators who might appeal to other, or not young, but two promising coordinators, Quinn's a little bit older, might appeal to other NFL teams. Maybe Jerry gets antsy about losing either Kellen Moore or Dan Quinn and dumps McCarthy to get the young blood in there, or at least younger blood in there. If you could only pick one, who would it be? MM for Mike McCarthy, KM for Kellen Moore, DQ for Dan Quinn. I don't want to discount. I think McCarthy's done a pretty good job this year overall. Cowboys have slightly exceeded expectations, but Dan Quinn's defense has been awesome this year. So you can only pick one. Who is it? Let me know in the comments. Finally, Robert Saleh. I don't think he gets fired. I want to have a nice, consistent 8 here. I think he stays. Frankly, I would be surprised if he ends up getting fired. It was not a good year for the Jets. That roster's also not ready to compete yet, but he does need to show growth next year, or it might once again be a reset for New York. I'll also make note, by the way, that guys like Dan Campbell, David Culley, a Zach Taylor for sure, those guys who entered the year maybe on the hot seat, began the year slowly, I think those guys have saved their jobs. I think you get to maybe maximum 6 of those guys get fired, but we'll see what happens as the season winds down.